Oh, hello, dears. Just spending a few idle moments in the library where I'm visiting with my old friend Leonardo. Specifically, this beautiful red chalk portrait of a warrior from the Battle of Anghiare. A forgotten battle, but certainly not a forgotten piece of art. Isn't it striking, dears? Isn't it extraordinary how, even though this is more than half unfinished sketch at that, with red chalk, it still has a vibrancy and it has an interest, doesn't it? I mean, you just can't look away. It is extraordinary in so many ways. You know, first of all, it's such an immediate sort of pose. I mean, this sort of pose in an actual person lasts only a fraction of a second. This fellow's barking out some sort of order, like, andiamo, or something, you know? And that just takes, fractions of a second. And here, he's captured it in every detail, although the details are not overwrought, are they? They're just sort of there. Equally so in this other picture that I must show you, that I know you've seen before, dears. But isn't this extraordinary? From the same series of sketches for this same large battle painting. And this fellow, obviously, in the throes of combat. And again, the sort of pose that can't last long. It's a very brief sort of expression of so much anguish and physical, complexity. And what I always find when I'm looking at these Leonardos, dears, is that it's so fresh. This could have been drawn literally, this afternoon, because there is a man, the sort of man that still walks the face of the earth today, and is indeed this sort of person who is involved in conflicts all over the world. And so there is that wonderful line that goes from Leonardo's time, the 1500s, he drew these in 1502, 1503, something like that, and that line to modern man where we can reach out and we can say, well, look, this is the sort of thing that was happening there. This man saw it. He noted it down, in a genius sort of way. And it really brings, I think, mankind together in a way, over the yawning span of time, in a way that only great art can. Anyway, it's always so inspiring. I wanted to share it with you. And now I'll let you get back to whatever you're doing. Oh, Professor Knestor Jackdaw's saying ta-ta. One feels one should keep one's voice hushed around Leonardo. It's not true. He was probably very, very vivacious, no doubt. Italian,